In the last video clip, I told you about the principles of solid phase synthesis. What I'm going to tell you about in this video clip is how to synthesize DNA by using solid phase synthesis. So this figure shows the structures of the components you use for DNA synthesis. The components are quite different from those of natural DNA. Here's a backbone structure you use for DNA synthesis. And these are the base structures for DNA synthesis. So looking at bases here, T is identical. T is identical to that in natural DNA. However, the other bases, A, G, C, are different. There are amino groups who trigger an unnecessary reaction in the chemical synthesis process, and therefore these amino groups are protected so that they do not react. These are all protected. So then these protections can be removed after the synthesis is completed. Then also, if you look at the structure of phosphate component right here, the phosphate component is also different from those of natural DNA. But this difference can increase the efficiency of the bonding with the next nucleotide. I'm going to tell you about later. The key component is the chemical group called DMT, right here. This part is called DMT, dimethoxytryptyl group. DMT is attached to the OH group, to which the next nucleotide is to be bonded. If we examine the process, we can see why DMT is essential to DNA synthesis. The first DNA nucleotide is attached to the large base. This is the first one. The first one is attached. Then DMT group is right here. The DMT is removed from the nucleotide by adding the acid to the solution. Then also, you have to prepare for the next one, next nucleotide. This is the next nucleotide. Next nucleotide is also protected by DMT. Then is going to be added. But before addition, this group needs to be activated for the beta coupling by tetrazole. So this is the activation process. Then this one is very reactive, they're ready for the coupling. Then these two are mixed together for coupling. Then if the next nucleotide is not protected by DMT, multiple molecules would be bonded to in succession, creating undesirable products. The oxidation of the phosphate components completes the addition of one DNA component right here. So if you look at the structure, this is not really a phosphate. The oxidation can give you the real phosphate group. In the series of reactions, the bases are rinsed and filtered every time a single reaction is completed, then to remove any non-reactive components. These steps eliminate the need to purify the desired product. So this is an excellent feature of solid phase synthesis. By repeating this process, long DNA strands can be synthesized chemically. And finally, DNA is cut from the beads with ammonia water. And the protected components from the bases are removed. Then you can get oligonucleotide. This repetitive synthesis technique is now automated and has made it possible to chemically synthesize DNA up to about 100 nucleotides in length. In the past, DNA oligonucleotides were synthesized manually with a syringe and filter. I still remember when I entered graduate school in Kyoto University, a DNA synthesizer manufactured in the United States was delivered to the laboratory. Something like this. Then we thought it was a dream machine. But today, the machine, similar to this synthesizer, is exhibited at the Smithsonian Museum of American History in Washington, D.C. So now this is a museum stuff now. Today, there is a DNA synthesizer capable of synthesizing 284 DNA nucleotides simultaneously. The old one used to be able to synthesize the oligonucleotide one by one. You can see this part has a filter unit here. That we put the beads right here. There's a filter here. Then we put A, T, Z, C here, and they are going to be coupled. Then these are all reagents. So then this machine, old machine, can make DNA one by one, but nowadays you can make it. You can make 384 DNA oligonucleotides simultaneously. So researchers no longer synthesize DNA in their own laboratories and instead use the services of companies equipped with large DNA synthesizers. It is possible now to place an order on the internet by 6 p.m. and receive synthesized DNA oligonucleotides on the following day. The automation has also permitted DNA synthesis in all environmental conditions. Because DNA synthesis works optimally in anhydrous conditions, the manual synthesis of DNA was not successful on rainy days in the past. So now you can synthesize whatever DNA you like up to about 100 nucleotides long. Despite these strides, new ideas were needed to generate longer DNA strands of DNA. In the next video clip, I'll tell you about how you can obtain and amplify longer DNA strands.